Good morning, children. Today we are discussing about work, energy, power. Well, in this lesson, present we are discussing about what is work, what is energy, what is power. So generally, the work is defined as simply say that the product of force and displacement is known as work. So what it says that the product of force and displacement is known as work, which is denoted by W. So here, when the body is placed on smooth horizontal floor, so mass of the body is considered as M. When we are applying force, the body gets displaced along the direction of force. So this is the displacement of the body. It gets displaced along the direction of force. Then work done is defined as the product of force and displacement is known as work. So simply say that another definition is that when the body is makes an angle with the force and displacement, this is displacement of the body. So here angle made between force and displacement, then work as defined as the product of component of force along the direction of displacement and magnitude of the displacement is known as work. So it is, this definition is belongs when angle made between force and displacement. Here the theta is equals to angle between force and displacement. So in this case, work is defined as the product of component of force. Here, which kind of component of force is there? Horizontal component of force. So horizontal component of force is expressed by F cos theta. So this F cos theta is along the direction of displacement and magnitude of the displacement is known as work. So according to this kind of definition, W becomes to F cos theta into S. So simply we write that Fs cos theta. Fs cos theta. So when actually what is work? Work nothing but the product of force and displacement. Simply definition. So when the force and displacement, the if a body gets displaced along the direction of force, then work done is equals to dot product of force and displacement. Then work is equals to dot product of force and displacement. Force is denoted by F, displacement is denoted by S. Then work done is equals to dot product of force and displacement. When it is equals to dot product of force and displacement, when the body gets displaced along the direction of force, then the work done is equals to dot product of force and displacement. When an angle between force and displacement, that angle is equals to theta, at that condition, work defined as the product of component of force along the direction of displacement and magnitude of the displacement is known as work. Here, the force can be divided into two parts, like force can be divided like two components, like horizontal component of force is F cos theta, vertical component of force is F sin theta. In this condition, which kind of force is along the direction of displacement? Here only F cos theta is applied along the direction of displacement. So that's why we write F cos theta into S. So how we can define the work? Work is nothing but the product of component of force along the displacement and magnitude of the displacement is known as work done. So W is can be written as F cos theta into S, simply written as Fs cos theta.
Force, when the body gets displaced along the direction of force, work done is equals to dot product of force and displacement. So the units of work in CGS units, what is the CGS unit of force? Dyne into, what is CGS unit of displacement? Centimeter. So the, what is the CGS unit of work? Dyne into centimeter. So in MKS unit, what is the MKS unit of force? Newton into displacement unit is meter. Newton into meter. So here the CGS unit is dyne into centimeter is nothing but 1 erg. It is equals to 1 erg. In MKS unit, what is the unit of work? Newton into meter. This is nothing but joule. So 1 joule is equals to how many erg's? So present we know that joule equals to Newton into meter. So the joule is a MKS unit of work. It is converted in CGS units. That's why here Newton and meter is also converted into CGS unit. Then 1 Newton equals to 10 to the power of 5 dyne. 1 meter is nothing but 100 centimeter. It can be written as 10 square. So 10 to the power of 5 plus 2, 7 dyne into centimeter. But dyne into centimeter is nothing but erg. So that's why 1 joule equals to 10 to the power of 7 ergs. Nature of work. Work done by a force may be positive. Work done by a force may be positive, negative, and zero. When it's positive, when it's negative, when it's zero. So present we are discussing about the nature of work. First of all, positive work. Positive work nothing but simply we define as when force and displacement are in same direction, then the work done by a force becomes to positive. So the force and displacement are in same direction, then work done by a force becomes to positive. So when W equals to generally Fs cos theta, when the force and displacement are in same direction, then angle made between force and displacement equals to zero. So W can be written as Fs cos zero. What is the value of cos 0? The value equals to 1 degree, 1. So Fs into 1, then W becomes to positive. So work becomes to here positive. When work becomes to positive, force and displacement are in same direction. At the situation, work done by a force becomes to positive. Generally, we know that W equals to Fs cos theta. Force and displacement are in same direction, theta becomes to 0. Fs cos 0 degree equals to 1. 1 into Fs, Fs, that's when W becomes to, work done becomes to positive. An angle between force and displacement theta at the condition of positive work, condition of positive work, 0 degree is equal, less than or equals to theta is less than 90 degrees. When work becomes to positive at that condition, what is the conditions for positive work?
0 degree is less than or equals to theta is less than 90 degrees. Next, second one is negative work. Negative work, when displacement, force and displacement are in opposite direction. This is the direction of force. This is the direction of displacement. Both are in opposite direction. Then angle made between force and displacement equals to 180 degrees. So in this situation, work done becomes to 180. Work done becomes to negative. Then W equals to Fs cos theta. Force and displacement are in opposite direction. At that situation, theta equals to 180. Fs cos 180. Cos 180 equals to minus 1. Fs into minus 1, then work done becomes to negative. Work done becomes to negative. Simple. In the example of positive work, the body gets displaced along the component of, this is the displacement of the body. When the body gets displaced along the component of force and the magnitude of displacement, at that condition work done becomes to positive. Here F cos theta and displacement of the body both are in same direction. At this situation work becomes to positive. Okay. Next. In negative work, force and displacement are both are in opposite direction. Then work done by a force becomes to negative. Actually, we know that W equals to Fs cos theta. Here, force and displacement are in opposite direction. Theta equals to 180. Cos 180 becomes to minus 1. Then work done by a force becomes to negative. In when angle between force and displacement is denoted by theta. Denoted by theta. Here, the condition for negative work, 90 degrees is less than theta is less than or equals to 180. What is the conditions for negative work? The condition is 90 degrees is less than theta is less than or equals to 180 degrees. Stop. Next, work done becomes to zero. Under three conditions, work done becomes zero. So that conditions are, actually what is the expressions of work? Fs cos theta. That's why the work is depend on first one force, second one displacement, and third one angle between force and displacement. When force is equals to zero, then work done is zero. Then displacement s equals to zero, then work done is also zero. Then angle between, it is also work is also depend on angle between force and displacement. Here force and displacement are normal to each other. Normal to each other. At this condition, work done is also zero. So present, we are discussing about where force is zero, work done is zero. The first condition is when force is zero, work done is zero. So see, for example, a body moving with uniform velocity or a bus moving with uniform velocity, it's moving with uniform velocity, then work done by the driver becomes to zero. Here bus moving with uniform velocity, there is no change in acceleration. the acceleration becomes to zero. Why? Because what is acceleration? The rate of change in velocity becomes to acceleration. So here there is no change in velocity. Velocity becomes zero, constant. That's why acceleration becomes to zero. There is no change in velocity. That's why acceleration becomes to zero. When acceleration becomes to zero, force is zero. Why because force is zero? Actually, we know that what is the expression of force? F equals to ma. A is zero. Then force becomes to also zero. Where force is zero, W is also zero. Why because W what is zero? F s cos theta. Here force is zero. So remaining value is s cos theta. It is also zero. So in this condition, work done is also zero. When work done becomes to zero, the applying force becomes to zero, work done becomes to zero. Simple example, when a bus or body moving with uniform velocity, work done by a body or work done by a driver becomes to zero. Next, second one, displacement of the body is zero. Displacement is denoted by S. When S is zero, work done is also zero. For example, when a person holding the weights in his hands, till 10 minutes. When a person holding the weights and standing at the horizontal floor till 10 minutes, there is no displacement of the person. That's why the work done by the person becomes to zero. Next, another one is when the force and displacement are normal to each other, work done is also zero. For example, a body moving on horizontal floor, this is the displacement of the body. Then the gravitational force, then the work done by gravitational force becomes to zero. Why? Because if a body moving along the smooth horizontal floor, then work done by a gravitational force becomes to zero. Because of here displacement of the body and gravitational force both are normal to each other. Here what is the angle between displacement and gravitational force? Angle between S and force equals to 90. What is the expression of work done? Fs cos theta. Here theta equals to 90 degrees. Why? Because force and displacement of the body both are normal to each other. So that's why Fs cos 90. Cos 90 degrees equals to 0, 0 into Fs, finally 0. In these three conditions, work done becomes to 0. First one, where force, applied force becomes to zero, work done zero. When the displacement of the body is zero, work done zero. When the force and displacement are normal to each other, work done is also zero.